Hi Simulation friends, and welcome to the third tutorial in my X-Plane 11 for Beginners series, where today I would like to show you how the views system of X-Plane 11 works, and especially how to set up all the camera angles within the virtual cockpit, and also because I got many questions about it, how to set up wing views. And all this can be accomplished with the default X-Plane 11 views system, so let's get right into this tutorial. At the moment we are situated at Düsseldorf International Airport, Echo Delta Delta Lima, and we are inside the cockpit of the Zeebo mod Boeing 737-800X. And as you might know from the last tutorial video, I just installed this plane completely fresh, so all the virtual cockpit cameras have to be set up again, and that's what we are going to do now. So by default when you start a flight, you will find yourself sitting in the virtual cockpit of the aircraft, at least if it's set up like this in the X-Plane 11 graphics settings. As you can see, the default view is forward with 3D cockpit, and you can also see my field of view, which is set to 80 degrees. So this will be the default view within the Zeebo 737 that we are starting off with, and there are no saved camera positions set up for this aircraft yet. And first of all we can have a look inside the menu bar of X-Plane 11 under View, where in the Move tab you can see all the keyboard commands for the camera controls. I'm going to explain those in detail in a minute, as well as the internal and external views that are available. Today we will concentrate on the forward view with the 3D panel, which by default can be accessed via Shift and 9. So if you rotate your camera with the right mouse button and you want to return to your default view, then you just hit Shift and 9 and we will have this view again. Let's also have a quick glance at the external views that are available. And these can be controlled via the Shift and 1 through 8 keys. So the most important external views to me are Shift and 2, which is a flyby view. Shift and 3 will be the runway view that I use a lot during replays to see the aircraft fly over the threshold of the runway and then land. Shift and 4 is the external view that I'm using most, as it's a nice rotating camera around the aircraft. And besides the virtual cockpit cam, this is the one I'm using most of the times. And Shift plus 5 is the tower view, which is also nice to have at times. And in X-Plane there's also the possibility to enter free camera mode at any time in the external views by hitting the C button, and then you can freely move around the camera, but we are going to cover the keyboard commands for the external movement a bit later. Now let's get back into the cockpit with Shift and 9. And I'm going to show you how to set up the virtual cockpit cameras first. As you might know, in X-Plane you can save up to 10 camera positions via the numpad keys 0 to 9. And there are also aircraft in X-Plane where views are preset already and you can access them via the numpad keys. But in most cases these views have to be set up manually. So now let's check out how to move the camera within the cockpit. The quickest and easiest way to move the camera is via the right mouse button. And you can also double-click the right mouse button, and then you don't have to hold the button any longer, but you can just move the mouse around. And by clicking the right mouse button again, you will exit that view mode. And there are also some very useful keyboard commands available to move the camera. And these are the arrow keys, left, right, up and down, as well as period and comma. Period moves forward and comma moves back. Q and E, so Quebec and Echo, pan the view left and right, and R and F, so Romeo and Foxtrot, move the camera up and down. All these movement buttons also have two modifiers, being Control or Shift. By holding Control and pressing these movement buttons, you will get a very slow movement for very precise adjustments, and by holding Shift while pressing these buttons, you get faster movement. So now I will show you how I like to set up my cockpit cameras, in this case for airliners, and also the wing views will follow. But first let's set up the most common and very frequently used camera views. So now I'm going to set up my preferred camera position for the pilot's view. So by using the keyboard buttons I set the camera position like this. And now to save this view, so that I can access it via the numpad 4 key, you hit the control key and then the numpad number you would like to save this camera to, so in this case control and 4. And now I have saved this view as number 4 on my numpad. After that I like to set up the co-pilot's view by hitting shift and the right button to get to his position fast, and then I'm hitting control and 6. So I save the pilot's position on number 4 and the co-pilot on number 6. Next up, I'm going to set up a close view to the instruments, to the main flight instruments. Yeah, somehow like this. And I'm going to hit Control and 1. And as you can see, I like to set up my views using the keyboard keys instead of using the right mouse button. And I do that so I don't get any tilted or not straight views, like this, as an exaggerated example. But by using the default camera position as a reference and then using the keyboard keys, you can be sure to always get perfectly aligned and straight views. But of course I don't do that for all the camera views, like for the FMC for example. Oh, and by the way, with you can zoom in and out with the mouse wheel, I didn't mention that yet. So if we go down here to the captain's FMC and we also zoom in a bit, I will save that view as Control and 2. And as you can see, also the zoom gets saved. Now let's do the similar thing for the co-pilot's FMC. And I'm going to save that view as Control and 3. Another very important view in the Zeebo aircraft is the AVTAP tablet. So I'm navigating there and I'm saving that view as numpad 5. So now there are two views left that I like to set up in the cockpit. And again, I'm using the keyboard keys to not get a tilted view. And this is a view for the pedestal. And I like to save that as number 0 on the numpad. So Control and 0. We'll save that view, and then we are rotating up to get a great view of the overhead. And I usually save that view as number 7, so Control and 7 on the numpad. So now you have seen how I like to set up my virtual cockpit cameras, and I received many questions how to set up these wing views within X-Plane 11 and if I'm using third-party programs for it, but it can all be accomplished via the default view system. So just by hitting Shift and Period, we are walking out of the cockpit and down the cabin. So as you can see, holding Shift while using Period and Comma is a lot faster than doing it without the modifier. So I'm looking for a nice wing view position. And to get rid of the window's frame, we are zooming in a bit until it mostly disappears. And I'm saving that view as number 8, so Control and numpad 8. And for the opposite side, I like to do it from before the wing, looking at the engine a bit. And some aircraft like the Zeebo have these wall restrictions for the camera, so you can't move the camera through the wall and outside the cabin. And for camera setups, that can be a bit hindering at times. So we can't get rid of the window's frame in this case. But I'm going to save this view as number 9 on the numpad. And that's it. Now we can quickly toggle through all the cams that we have, be it wing view cams or back inside the virtual cockpit. And before finishing this tutorial, let's also quickly cover the camera movement in external view. So I hit Shift and 4 for my preferred external view. And you can also right here zoom in and out. Move the camera with the right mouse button, and also the keyboard keys have the same functions pretty much. So the arrow keys will whiz around the aircraft, and by holding Control it will be very slow and smooth, and Shift will be fast. Also the Q, E, R and F keys are working, and the period and comma keys as well for moving forward and aft. And if you enter free camera by hitting C, Charlie, then you can also move the camera with the mouse. These are the arrow keys in action. And also Q, E, R and F are working again. But in this view it's the same as in the cockpit. You can also do it with the right mouse button. And you can very quickly fly over your aircraft and over the airport by holding Shift and Period in this case and using the right mouse button. And the same applies to Shift and arrow key up, for example. To get up into the air very quickly, left, right, down, all these keys are working as well in this view. And one final thing that you can do regarding the views system in X-Plane 11 is the possibility to enable the so-called Cinema Verite. Cinema Verite. By using this menu entry or hitting Shift and C. and this will enable a random head movement. And I think in flight it will also react to turbulences and such things, if I'm not mistaken. I haven't used this function too much. But if you would like to make the cameras a bit less static, then you can also enable this function. But the preferred method for this would be the free Headshake plugin by Simcoders. And if you're interested, these are the settings that I'm using for my Headshake plugin. So again, if you are new to Xplain, I hope that this video could help you a bit with understanding the Vue system. And if you liked it, then please leave a thumbs up and subscribe for more tutorial videos and flight videos to come very soon. So have a great day, and until next time, see ya!